Hello everyone, I am Neeru from Pinnacle Online Coaching Classes. Today we are going to do SSC CGL Tier 1 paper and the paper code is 881. I am going to do the general awareness section with you for this paper 881. This is part of an entire series. Pinnacle is offering 50 online tests based on the new pattern given by SSC from paper code 851 to paper code 900. And for all these tests, there are accompanying video lectures for you to understand better so that your score can improve. All those students who wish to join them can join them by visiting our website sscclpinnacle.com. sscclpinnacle.com, that's the name of my website. And those students who have joined our test series, only for them all the video lectures are going to be available. Rest, only few are there in the public domain. So now let's begin general awareness section of paper code 881. First question: why does an electric bulb bang when it breaks? Whenever an electric bulb it breaks, there's a vacuum inside and you'll hear a sound, bang sound. Okay, why is it so? Question from science: because it is made of glass, because the glass is thin, the electric wire in the bulb causes the bang, or there is a partial vacuum in the electric bulb and when it is broken, the air rushes into the vacuum because causing the bang. Absolutely right. Answer D is the correct one. There is a vacuum inside the electric bulb and when it is broken, the air rushes into the vacuum causing the bang. Question number 26, answer is D. 7. The painted greyware is associated with. Question from history: what is painted greyware associated with? The Paleolithic age, the Neolithic age, the Bronze age, or the Iron age? Now, the Indus Valley has a great and ancient tradition of pottery making. The pottery making period, pottery making, very, very important in the development of man, pottery making. In fact, the wheel was first used for the potter's wheel and later on it was used in transport. The origin of pottery in India can be traced back to the Neolithic age with coarse handmade pottery. So the painted greyware is associated with, for question number 27, answer is B, the Neolithic age. In the Neolithic age, neo means new and lithic means stone. It is associated with coarse handmade pottery, bowls, jars, vessels in different colors such as red, orange, brown, black and cream. The real beginning of Indian pottery is with the Indus Valley civilization. Question number 27. In fact, in the Indus Valley civilization, there were pictures on the pots that were made, and we have a story in the Panchatantra of the clever fox which is sitting under a tree, and then there is a crow on the tree which has a small bit of food in its mouth, and it tells the crow how beautifully you sing. That Panchatantra story, it is even depicted on one of the pots found in the Indus Valley civilization. So question number 27, my answer is B. 28. Mandal Commission. Mandal Commission report pertains to, the Mandal Commission report pertains to backward classes, minorities, scheduled caste or scheduled tribes. Question number 28, answer is A, it pertains to the backward classes. Mandal Commission was established in India in 1979. It was established by the Janata Party government with Prime Minister Morarji Desai with the mandate to identify social or educationally backward. The Mandal Commission was there. So question number 28, you can say it's from polity. Answer for question number 28 is A. Next is question number 29. Simple question this is. Question number 29 from science: which of the following is the correct sequence in order of increasing power consumption? So which of the following will consume the least power? Options are television, fan, electric kettle or electric iron. Television, fan, electric iron or electric kettle. Fan, television, electric kettle, electric iron. Fan, television, electric iron or electric kettle. Whenever things in your house are running on an inverter and there's a scarcity, there's a power scarcity, in that situation you will notice what will we first switch off. We are first going to switch off the television, the fan, the electric kettle or the electric iron. Which of these are you going to switch off first? Question number 29, here for question number 29, the right answer is C. The fan will be the last to be switched off because fan consumes the least power. Maximum power is consumed by electric iron, then by electric kettle, then by the TV, and lastly by the fan. So this is the order for question number 29. Answer is C. Fan, television, electric iron, electric kettle. Question number 30. Which of the following is the second longest river in the world? Question number 30. Answer is B. Amazon. Amazon is the second longest river in the world. The first longest is the Nile River. The country Egypt is known as the gift of the Nile. So, and this river, Yangtze Kiang, this is in China. And this one, this is in North America. So, which is the longest river? Nile is the longest river. Amazon, this is the second longest river in the world. A question from geography. Next is question number 31 from science. Constipation can be prevented by taking food containing fiber. And which of the following contains fiber? So, if one is suffering from constipation, then he should take food containing fiber. But which of the food contains fiber? Firstly, let us understand what is fiber. What are my options? Fruits, sugar, vegetables, or starch. What is fiber? Fiber is also known as roughage, and it is the indigestible part of plant food, and it pushes through our digestive system, absorbing water along the way and easing bowel movement. So, if one is suffering from constipation, most important thing, what does he need? He needs to ease his bowel movements. Ease his bowel movements, that's going to help him in his constipation. So, constipation can be prevented by taking food containing fiber. Fruits that are rich in fiber are apples, blackberries, pears, raspberries, and banana. So, question number 31, answer for question number 31 is A. Fruits. 32 from polity. Question number 32, polity. India, that is Bharat, shall be a union of states. This is what is given to us. India, that is Bharat, shall be a union of state. This is mentioned in which article of our constitution? In the very beginning of our constitution, article 1, it tells us what is going to be the name of our country. In fact, this was one point in which the members of the Constituent Assembly, they did not have consensus. Some of them wanted a modern name. They said that now we are going to be a part of the UNO and there's going to be international representation. So, let's keep the name India. But some of them wanted a name which reflected our tradition, our culture, etc., our past, our rich heritage. So, they wanted a name Bharat. That is the reason that both these names have been included in the Constitution. It says India, that is Bharat, shall be a union of states, and this is given in the very first article of the Constitution, Article 1. This occurs in which articles of the Constitution? In Article 1. It says, Article 1 says, India, that is Bharat, shall be a union of states. This is the only provision in the Constitution of how the country is going to be referred for official and unofficial purposes. Article 6, 7 and 8, which have also been mentioned in this question, they are all about the citizens' rights. Question number 38, who will be a citizen and all that, that is dealt with in 6, 7 and 8. Next is question number 34, red corpuscles are to hemoglobin as chloroplasts are to. Question number 34, answer is C, chlorophyll. Chloroplast, important ingredient of chlorophyll. So, question number 34 from biology and answer is C. Next is question number 35 from the Indian National Movement. Promotion of Tata Iron and Steel Company was initiated by. Promotion of Tata Iron and Steel Company was initiated by Swadeshi Movement, Civil Disobedience Movement, CDM, both of the above or none of the above. These are my options. Okay. Question number 35. Now, when was the Tata Iron and Steel industry set up? The plans to be set up started from 1903, but finally by 1907, it was set up. And when did partition of Bengal take place? It took place in the year 1905, although it was announced well in advance that such a thing is going to take place by Lord Curzon. And then there was an anti-partition of Bengal movement in which Swadeshi became a very, very important weapon. And it was there was overall there was an environment where people wanted to boycott foreign goods and they wanted to adopt goods made in India. This would have really hurt the British Empire. That Swadeshi was a part of anti-partition of Bengal movement. And it was at this time that there was a proposal to set up an iron and steel in the factory in Jamshedpur, which is located in the current day state of Jharkhand. So question number 35, let's take a look at the explanation first. What does Swadeshi means? Swadeshi means of one's own country. Swadeshi was a part of the movement that began against the partition of Bengal, and it meant people should use Indian products to strengthen the nation through promotion of Indian industries and provide better employment opportunities to unskilled, unemployed craftsmen. It would be an effective method of developing patriotism, and Acharya P.C. Roy and Rabindranath Tagore, they opened Swadeshi stores at this time. Remember these two names also. And it was in this movement that Jamshedji Tata also established an iron and steel factory at Jamshedpur, the first iron and steel factory in India. Question number 35. So what is going to be my answer for question number 35? It's A, Swadeshi movement. 35 A. Question number 36. The coil of an electric heater is made of. What is the coil of an electric heater made of? It's made of zinc, brass, copper or nichrome. These are my options. Answer is nichrome. Coil of an electric heater, it's made of nichrome, which is an alloy. It has 90% nickel and 20% chromium. That's how the name comes, nichrome. Okay, it's a nichrome 80-20 ratio. It's an ideal material because it has relatively high resistance and forms an adherent layer of chromium oxide when it is heated for the first time. Question from science. Question number 36. Answer is D. Next is question number 37. Question number 37, you can say it's related to books and authors. At the same time, you can say it's related to history also. Which of the following is not a work of Kalidas? You must have heard the name of Kalidas, one of the best writers, one of the best writers from ancient India. Okay, Kalidas. Which of the books is not written by him? Raghu Vamsha, Meghdoot, Kumara Sambhava or Devi Chandra Guptam. These are my options. And now I'm going to tell you in detail about the books of Kalidas. Kalidas, first and foremost, he was a Navratan. Navratan in the court of Chandragupta Vikramaditya. He was a Navratan in his court, and he is a classical Sanskrit writer and is regarded as the greatest poet and dramatist of Sanskrit language. And now let's talk about his books. His book Malvikagni Mitram. You could be given a question as to Shunga King, Agni Mitra and Malvika. They are the characters in which book of Kalidas? Answer is Malvikagni Mitram. Malvikagni Mitram, it's a Sanskrit play. It is the love story of a Shunga King, Agni Mitra and Malvika, a maidservant. Next is Abhijanam Shakuntalam. This is the story of the King Dushyant of Hastinapur and Shakuntala, who was the daughter of Vishwamitra, and this is his most famous book. Then we have Vikramovarshiyam. Next is Raghuvamsha. Raghuvamsha, this is a Sanskrit epic poem and it narrates the genealogy of Lord Rama, beginning from King Dilip up to Agni Varna. Then we have Kumara Sambhava. Kumara Sambhava, this is the book about the birth of Kartikeyan, who is the son of Shivji and Parvati. Ritu Samhara, this is an interesting book in which the feelings, Ritu means season, and there are six seasons, and in this book the feelings on emotions and experiences of lovers in these six seasons have been depicted, and Ritu Samhara is considered to be the earliest work of Kalidas. Then the next is Meghdoot, which is, Megh means a cloud and Doot is a messenger, so messenger of clouds, Meghdoot. This is also one of his books. All these are by Kalidas. Then in the same Gupta period, there is another writer, Vishakhadatt. Vishakhadatt has written two important historical plays. One is Mudra Rakshasa and the next is Devi Chandraguptam. Devi Chandraguptam, it survives in fragments only today, and Mudra Rakshasa means the ring of the demon. And it narrates the rising of Chandragupta Maurya to throne. How did Chandragupta Maurya come to the throne? The book is about him. Rakshasa, this is the last minister of Nanda's who is lured on Chandragupta's side by Chanakya. In fact, it is in this book that Chandragupta Maurya has been called Kulheen. You could be given a question as to in which book has Chandragupta Maurya been called Kulheen. This is the answer. And he has written another book known as Devi Chandraguptam. Devi Chandraguptam, it is the story of Dhruva Devi, who was a queen in the Gupta period. So this is all about the books. Now let us go back to the question. Which of the following is not a work of Kalidas? The last option, Devi Chandraguptam. Because this is not written by Kalidas, it has been written by Vishakhadatta. Question number 38 related to science. The ecological association of dissimilar organism to their mutual advantage is called. Different types of organisms, two really opposite organisms, they will get together and their existence depends upon one another. What is this called? This ecological association of dissimilar organisms to their mutual advantage is called symbiosis, parasitism, saprophytism or food chain. This is known as symbiosis. Like for example, if you see this one, now the bee will get the honey from the flower, which is its food, the nectar, and in return, what is the benefit for the flower? In return, the bee is going to pollinate the flower. Bees will help in pollination. They are one of the largest agents of pollination. So it is a mutual advantage to both. Another example, where crows etc. sitting on animals like buffaloes and cows, they feed on the small lice and ticks which are there on the cow. Now the cow will get rid of the lice and ticks, and for the crow or the bird sitting on top, it's their food. This is an example of symbiosis, where animals associate with each other for their mutual advantage. Answer is A. The bees get nectar to make honey and it pollinates the flower. At the same time, let me explain to you what is parasitism, saprophytism also. Now, question number 38, the ecological association of dissimilar organisms to their mutual advantage is called symbiosis. Symbiosis is close and often long-term interaction between two biological species. Commensalism, parasitism and saprophytism now. In commensalism, a type of symbiotic interaction in which one organism benefits from the host without causing benefit or harm to it. That is commensalism. In the first one in symbiosis, both were benefiting. In the second one, only one benefits, but neither does it cause a loss or harm to the other one. In parasitism, like for example, suppose if you have lice in your hair, that is parasitism. Because it is going to cause harm to you. When the harm is being caused to the host, then it becomes parasitism. A type of symbiotic interaction in which one organism lives at the expense of the others. Tapeworms in our stomach, that is an example of parasitism. Because they are not doing any good to us, they are only doing harm to us. And what is saprophytism? It's the ability of certain plants to live on dead and decaying organic matter, fungi, etc. Question number 38, answer is A. Next is question number 39. The Diwani of Bengal, Bihar and Orissa was acquired by the British in the year 1715, 1757, 1764, 1765. Here is a question from modern India. Question number 39. Let's try and look at the explanation first. Question number 39, answer is D. 39 answer is D. The Diwani of Bengal, Bihar and Orissa to East India Company was given by the Mughal Shah Alam in 1765. This was after the Battle of Buxar. A Treaty of Allahabad was signed. It was signed on 16th August 1765. Please remember by which treaty were the Britishers given the Diwani of Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. Answer is Treaty of Allahabad. Who signed this treaty on behalf of the Mughals? It was Mughal Shah Alam. Which date? 16th August 1765. First remember these points. Okay. It was signed between the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II, son of late Emperor Alamgir II and Robert Clive of East India Company. It was a result of Battle of Buxar, which was fought on 22nd October 1764. And this treaty marked the political and constitutional involvement and the beginning of British rule in India. It was based on terms of agreement. Alam granted the East India Company Diwani rights or the right to collect taxes on behalf of the emperor from eastern province of Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. Question number 39. My answer is D, 1765. Question number 40 related to biology. The teeth used for biting and cutting food are incisors, molars, wisdom teeth or canine. These are my four options. Question number 40. Answer is going to be the teeth used for biting and cutting are. They are known as incisors. Now let me show you human teeth. Incisors, this what are they? It's a narrow edged teeth in the front of the mouth adapted for cutting. In humans, there are four incisors in each jaw. Molars or molar teeth, these are large flat teeth found towards the back of the mouth and they are used for grinding and chewing the food. Okay, after you've taken a bite, you will take it towards the back of your mouth and there you will try to eat it between the molars. Then wisdom teeth or third molar, this is one of the three molars pre-quadrant of the human dentition. It is the most posterior of the three. Wisdom tooth, this is one tooth which you will get around the wisdom teeth, you will get around the ages of 17 and 25 in between this period. Canine teeth, these are the pointed teeth you see in the front, canine teeth. In mammalians, oral anatomy, canine teeth is also called cuspid. Dog teeth, fangs or eye teeth are relatively long pointed teeth. Question number 40. Now let me show you the teeth here. You will be able to understand better. Now here you can see these are the incisors from here till here. This is the central incisor right in front. Okay. Sometimes you see gap between these. Here this is the canine. It's going to be slightly pointed, used for tearing, etc. These are the premolars. These are the premolars, the first premolar and the second premolar. And here at the here right at the back, you will see the wisdom tooth. You will see the wisdom tooth right here, and these are used for grinding and grinding the food and eating it better. This is used for tearing the food. If you're eating chicken or something like that, you're a non-vegetarian, this is used for simply biting the food. Okay, so these are the human teeth. Question number 41. Atolls are similar to barrier reefs except that they are going to be circular in shape. Atolls are similar to barrier reef except that they are small, large, circular in shape or none of the above. Answer for question number 41 is C. An atoll, sometimes called a coral atoll, it's a ring shaped or circular in shape coral reef. Next is question number 42 related to world geography and that to political. Okay, political geography of the world. Let us see the question. Which of the following are landlocked countries of South America? My options are Bolivia and Paraguay, Bolivia and Ecuador, Uruguay and Paraguay, and or Guyana and Paraguay. These are my options. Now, in South America, only two countries are landlocked. What's a landlocked country? A landlocked country is that country which is surrounded by land on all sides. Is India a landlocked country? No, we have a nice coastline. Is Nepal a landlocked country? Yes, it is surrounded by land on all sides. Let me first show you a map here. This is the map of South America. Now let us take a look at which countries are landlocked. We have Venezuela here, but Venezuela has a coastal region. Then we have Colombia, we have Ecuador, here we have Peru, then we have Chile here, we have Bolivia. Is Bolivia landlocked? Correct. Is Paraguay landlocked? Correct. Which is the largest country of South America? It's Brazil. Then we have Chile here. It has a long coastline. We have Argentina. This also has a nice coastline. Here we have Uruguay. It has a coastline. Only two countries, as I told you, they are landlocked. Which are they? Number one is Bolivia. Number two is Paraguay. All the others have a coastline. What's a landlocked country? A country that is landlocked. Is one that has no direct access to open seas. This means that the country is entirely surrounded by land on all sides. South America is the fourth largest continent in the world. It has 12 countries. Of these countries, it has 12 sovereign countries and two non-sovereign countries. Of these countries in South America, two are landlocked, Bolivia and Paraguay. So question number 42, my answer is A, Bolivia and Paraguay. Next is question number 43, which was the first state to ban e-cigarettes? Question number 43, first state to ban e-cigarettes in our country, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala or Karnataka. Now, question number 43, what are e-cigarettes? They are electronic cigarettes. E-cigarette has been banned in some state as its use can cause various health issues including cancer and heart ailments. I would like to make one thing clear that if you search on the net, you will get Punjab as the first state which has banned e-cigarettes. But then after searching a bit more in detail, what Pinnacle has found out is that the Hindu newspaper had published an article regarding e-cigarettes and banning them, and in that Karnataka was mentioned as the first state to ban e-cigarettes. That's the reason that we are going to go with Karnataka, because Hindu is a very authentic newspaper. Which was the first state to ban e-cigarettes? Question number 43, we will go with Karnataka. It's not going to be Kerala, it's going to be Karnataka. Kerala is the fourth entrant in this. Kerala is not the answer. I'm going to correct this. 43 is D. Karnataka was the first state to ban e-cigarettes. Is covered here. Other states that have banned e-cigarettes are Punjab, Maharashtra, and Kerala. So far, there are four states which have banned e-cigarettes, beginning with Karnataka, then Punjab, Maharashtra, and Kerala. Kerala is the fourth one. Question number 43. Current GK. Question number 44. The President of India may seek the advice of the Supreme Court on any question of law or fact of public importance under the Supreme Court's which jurisdiction? Is it original jurisdiction? Is it advisory jurisdiction? Is it appellate jurisdiction, or it is none of the above? Let me make it clear to you. In original jurisdiction, the matter has gone to the court for the first time. That means can the president go directly to the court, original jurisdiction. Then advisory jurisdiction, when he is seeking the advice of the court. Appellate jurisdiction, the matter has gone through appeals. First it went to a lower court, then higher, and then the highest. That way. So question number 44, the President of India may seek the advice of the Supreme Court on any question of law or fact of public importance under Supreme Court's advisory jurisdiction. Question number 44, answer is going to be B. Let's take a look. What is advisory jurisdiction? Remember one more point, that advisory jurisdiction has been covered in Article 143 of the Constitution. Article 143, power of president to consult Supreme Court. If at any time it appears to the president that a question of law or fact has arisen or is likely to arise, which is of such a nature or of such public importance that it is necessary to obtain the opinion of the Supreme Court upon it, he may refer the question to the court for consideration, and the court may, after hearing as it thinks fit, report to the president its opinion thereon. So question number 44, B is the answer. Next is 45. Cost push inflation is caused by abolition of resale price maintenance and increase in propensity to save, or world scarcity of basic raw materials, or increase in investment. Answer is C. Cost push inflation is caused by an increase in prices of inputs like labor, raw material, etc. The increased price of factors of production leads to a decreased supply of these. So this is called cost push inflation. And what is inflation? That there are very few goods in the market, so the price is increasing of these goods. That's known as inflation. And when cost is the total cost incurred in producing the goods. So cost push inflation will lead to world scarcity of basic raw material. 46, where is penicillin produced in India? Answer is A, Pimpri. This is in Maharashtra. Pimpri is a suburb of Pune in the state of Maharashtra, and here penicillin is produced. Question number 47, rolling plan can be best defined in the context of India as what exactly is a rolling plan? Its formulation of annual plans, its perspective of 5 years plan with the provision of extending by 1 year at a time so that there could be constant planning, horizon of 5 years, aims and achievements reviewed every year in 5 years plan or plan for full 5 years. In rolling plan, what happens? You are planning for 5 years, perspective of 5 years plan with the provision of extending by 1 year at a time so that there would be constant planning horizon for 5 years. That's a rolling plan. Question number 47B. The highest point of Satpura Range is a question from Physical Geography of India. The highest point of Satpura Range is Dhoopgarh in Panchmadi. This is the answer. Nokrek, Parasnath, Mahendragiri, these are all incorrect. Question number 48A. Satpura Range, this is a range of hills in central India. Highest point of Satpura Range is Dhoopgarh, Panchmadi. Question number 48A is your correct answer. Next, question number 49. Guzak. Guzak is the name of a place where G-H-U-Z-A-K. It's a question. Rare question. This is the place where Jaipala met his enemy Subuddin. Mahmud crushed defeat on Jaipala. Jaipala burnt himself on a funeral pyre since he was unable to survive the disgrace caused by the defeat at the hands of Mahmud, or none of the above. None of the above. Here the question is related to Mahmud, M-A-H-M-U-D, Mahmud of Ghazni, G-H-A-Z-N-I. He is being referred to as Subuddin here. Now, he had made plenty of attacks on India, almost 17 attacks of India, and he looted India and took away almost everything from India wherever he attacked. Okay, he specifically targeted the rich temples. And during one of his such raids, he had to fight against Jaipala, who was a Hindu king. He was a Hindu king. So Guzak was the place where Jaipala and Mahmud of Ghazni fought, or it was the place where Mahmud crushed a defeat on Jaipala. And Jaipala was of course defeated, and after that, it's a very rare example in history that Jaipala, he burnt himself on a funeral fire because he felt highly disgraced. It's that place or it's none of the above. Question number 49, answer is A. Jaipala met his enemy Subuddin. 49 is A. Last question to be done, question number 50. Question number 50 of paper code 881. Which state in India has become the first state to approve sewage and wastewater policy? Question number 50, answer is A. Rajasthan. So that was the last question to be done. And if you wish to join Pinnacle Online Test Series, you wish to watch all these video lectures that we are making, because we are making supporting video lectures for each and every paper that we are making, so that the students can take the maximum benefit, they can work upon this course, and we are trying to cover variety questions from all areas so that maximum coverage of syllabus is given. If you wish to join, visit our website sscclpinnacle.com. That's our website. Visit it, and whichever test series you feel is suitable for you, you can join that. I wish you all the very, very best. Thank you.